Well, but he said, when you see these things, they're going to show you that it's true. Well, embryonic recapitulation. Is that something, is it something, as he said up here, that was a mistake and that has been corrected? Is that true? Well, not so quickly. Let me show you the drawings that were done back in the 1800s, showing what he's talking about, how you start as you develop inside of the mother's womb. You start off and you'll have gill slits and you'll have a tail and you'll have a yolk sac. So as you're developing inside the mother's womb, you're not totally human. At one point you have a reptilian heart and you have the yolk sac. And guys, you don't think that's still in the school system. Just 3 days ago, I was up in Michigan doing a youth event. Young lady comes up to me after the event with her mother, and the mother's like, my daughter has a question, would you answer it? I said, I'll do my best. And she's like, I just got taught in school that we have gill slits as we're developing. How do we go from having gill slits to becoming humans? I mean, we're like a fish when we're developing. It is still in the schools. When he tells me that has been corrected, that is a bold-faced lie. By the way, Satan doesn't have to play fair. He doesn't have to play fair. He can boldface lie. There's no consequences from that worldview. There's nothing wrong with me lying in that worldview. For me, I take it seriously because I got a millstone hanging around my neck if I'm giving you all bad information. So when he tells me that that's been corrected, well, let's take a look at this book right here. This is a modern book. And when you take a look at what it says inside of the book there, let's take a look here. Early developmental stages of animals whose adult forms appear radically different are often surprisingly similar. Neo-Darwinian mechanisms explain why embryos of different species so often resemble each other in their early stages, and as they develop, seem sometimes to replay the steps of evolution. So these things look similar as they're developing because they come from the same source. By the way, let's take a look at the actual embryos. These are photographs of the actual embryos and see how similar they are. I mean, it's very hard to tell them apart, right? Guys, it's a bold-faced lie. You've got to teach your children the truth. Watch this. You don't think those diagrams are still used in the textbooks today? Take a look at that. You see those pictures? Those are Haeckel's drawings from the 1800s. They were proven fraudulent in the 1800s, and they are still in the textbooks today. Take a look. Let's overlap the two pictures. Oh, that's a problem. That's been corrected. Really? Then why are the pictures still in the textbook? You're being lied to, and your children are being deceived. That's reality.